Hi there, and welcome to the webinar on steroids video walkthrough. I just want to take you through the assets that are included in this funnel when you purchase it. Obviously, everything is already there, which I'm about to show you. You just have to go through, change your wording, your logo, and any images that you want to change out. So, let's start with the opt-in page. So, this is the opt-in page. There's a countdown timer there which you would set at just a few minutes. It is actually already set at that, but because this webinar, obviously I've been looking at this page to do this video, so it's not showing the minutes. Then down here, there's a bit about you and some key points of what they'll get in the webinar and some testimonials. Now, everything in this site is already linked up, everything in this funnel, right down to your terms and conditions there. There's a template right there. So in this funnel, once you opt in, you get taken to this page. Now this page is ready set at about 15 minutes and it says, in the meantime, grab a pen and paper, download the worksheet, which you can link right here. And after this clock ends, it will automatically take them to the webinar. Now this isn't a big faking a webinar. This is a completely automated evergreen webinar. You can run it all year round. You don't have to keep recording it. You just have a pre-recorded webinar that plays. Now here in the webinar, they can actually watch the video. As soon as they land on this page, I'm going to hit refresh. When they land on this page, it starts playing immediately. Now underneath this, there's a short spiel, which I'll show you soon, that is a little bit about the offer that shows up about 20 minutes in. You can change that time really easily. Then if they skip that, it goes through, there is a replay page that they are getting sent in the email sequence. I'll show you the email sequence in a second. The replay page looks very much like this. In fact, the only reason we send them to the replay page and not this one is so that you can actually see that they've gone to the replay. Now I am just going to click into this page so you can see what is underneath this video. Okay, so you can see here that it has the offer end. So this whole section shows up. You can change it right here in the settings. There's a delay for this section, which is at 900 seconds. So that is however many minutes that is. So this section in the blue and this section in the white only show up at that time. Okay, so after that shows up at the bottom, and also when this video gets to the point where you're making the offer, the button will actually show up within the video so they can click through to the offer. So this is the sales page that they get. This is set up to expire just over 4 days from when they touch this page. So there is a legit cutoff time. So to give you an idea of what the page looks like, you can have a sales video there, a bit about the program, bit more about the program and the benefits and testimonials, if there's modules, what modules or components are available, bonuses, a bit about you, more testimonials, bit more about the program and how they can get some sort of ROI. See, each of these sections actually tells you about what you need to put in the placeholder content as well. And down the bottom, you've set up for two different price points, a one-time payment or a pay plan. The product is also already set up and already connected, so you can just change the title and change your price. So you go to your shopping cart like this, and it will be set up to get their details. Go to the next step. If you set up PayPal and Stripe, it'll give you both those options there, and the same happens with the 3Pay. Now, if after that 4-day period or whatever you set your timer to, it expires, then they will be sent some emails through the sequence, but then they get sent to this offer expired page. So you have a legit cutoff time from whenever it is that they opt into the funnel and when they land on that sales page. So I just want to show you inside the assets. As I mentioned, we've got a product that's already connected to that sales page. We have lists so people can sign up as an affiliate. We have affiliate pages there for you as well. Obviously the form, the list when they opt in and then when they become a buyer. We've got many tags here, when they buy the product, when they register, when they abandon cart, sign up as an affiliate, And then all of these tags are actually set for your videos. So, you know, when they've watched to the end, if they got out before the pitch was done, if they only watched the first minute of the webinar, if they start to watch a webinar and don't watch anymore, or they click the offer button in the video. They're all tagged here, and the sequences can kick off depending on the actions they take. Now, here's all the pages that are in there. They are numbered from number one here, registration, then the confirmation of registration, then it will automatically send them to the webinar replay room here, sorry, the webinar room there, then the webinar replay room is there. You have your terms and conditions, as I said, which is a template with all the right wording that I use. Definitely, if you've got your own terms and conditions, put it in there. It's merely a template. Then after that, they go to the sales page. The sales page is here, as I showed you. And if they do purchase the order, there's the confirmation page, then the expiry page if they don't grab the order in time. This is a page where they can sign up as an affiliate, or people can, so you can set that for them, how much your commission is. You can give them examples of kind of marketing material you give them. Then once they are an affiliate, they land on this page, and you can give them images, whatever you need to give them to actually promote this offer for you. So that is the pages that's set up, the sequences that are set up. We have webinar registration, which is thank you for registering. And then that has a follow-up, sending them the replay. If they didn't get tagged to say they watched more than that first minute, then they get kicked off in this sequence where they left the webinar early and they missed the offer. So it sends them a link directly to the offer page so they can have a look at that. Now, there is an automation, so they get taken out of both of those sequences if they purchase, so they're not going to get marketed to. So the forms, we've got the opt-in form, and then we've got the affiliate sign-up form. Now, in this, we've got two videos. One's just a video placeholder. The other one's a webinar placeholder. This is the webinar placeholder that has all of the tagging based on time. You can go into this video, replace it with your actual webinar, and then depending on the timing of your webinar, you just have to change the times of those tags so that the people know, so you know, and the sequences know whether they've watched the offer and so on. And then the final thing is just the help desk. So the help desk can be live chat, ticket support, and you can have that pop up throughout the webinar so that they can contact you if they have questions, or during the webinar, if they've got questions, they can talk to you through here. So that's everything that we have included in this webinar funnel. It's one that I've used many a time, works really well. So if that's something that you're interested in, this template is all connected, it's ready to go, and you can just change it for your own branding. Thank you so much, and I'll see you on the other side.